Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Tigerblaze Playz Terraria. So to start things off today, we need to find the steampunker. As she literally just moved in and started recording. Let's just look on the map. Yeah, she's in this house over here for some reason. Well, let's hurry over there. And buy what we need to buy. Luckily, I checked before I started recording. We do have enough gold. So that's convenient, I guess. It's trippy. Like, this map here is so trippy. Get the... Even. So yeah, we need it. Oh. Okay. I thought those were more expensive. Tell me if those were always 250 and I'm just going crazy, or if they were 10 gold past. Seriously, because I thought they were 10 gold. That gives us a lot more money for this. Oh, our pilots. The worst enemy. Have to fight. Okay. That bit. Okay. We have turtle armor now, so should we... Eh, so we should be a lot more tame. Oh, hey look, another life fruit. We need a lot of these things, by the way. Like, to get up to max golden hearts. Okay, just take care of you. Okay, also, and for those of you who think that, being happy about getting a 5 health doesn't kill us, it doesn't mean much. That moment when having just one more health point would have allowed you to survive. That's an annoying feeling. Okay, we're taking care of some of it. Something. But unless we do something, major, we aren't going to get there. Oh, and Wrangler arrived. Oh, there's a Plantarable. Not the one I expected to get to. We found a few. Leave one of them. That was close. And did you see that texture glitch with the life group? Well, if you didn't notice it, then, the strategy I'm going to be using against Plantera is a strategy that has been, tried and true for a long time. Nothing new. I'm going to need a long hallway and a lot of cleared space. You guys probably know it. I'm using the teleporter method. In my opinion, one of the more viable Terra first battle strategies. In expert mode, I normally wouldn't consider it necessary or even incredibly helpful. But now that we're in expert mode, it's quite necessary. Everywhere. Hopefully as long as we stay in. We'll be able to fix it like directly before the fight, so I don't have an issue. We get enough gold. That, or at least that much. It's another life fruit. I'm going to need to dig a lot of this. Rather, I'll probably dig it out and replace it with platforms. But for the time being, this works. And the reasoning behind that is, Plantera has a certain attack that unless I do something like that, I'm just going to be very anxious. Possibly. Obviously, that art of feet doesn't. Let's take a look at this chest. Oh, how useful that would have been. Like, we entered hard mode. Jeez. I'm pretty sure we have water walking boots somewhere, don't we? We could make some lava waders. Could be nice, I guess. Not sure why I'd need them. Hope so much for that. But I think that's enough digging. So, I'm going to, fix up some things and whatnot, get the arena ready, and, I'll be back in a bit. Okay, guys, I finished the arena. Now, here comes the real part. Real fight. The fight. I don't need to. Okay. Okay. Well, it's doing something, right? Is it working? Honestly not sure. Yeah, it's really not working. Blocks now. Okay, then. Well, I thought that strategy was surefire. That I was dead wrong. Okay, well, that's enough of puns. I guess I'll try to think up a new way to beat Terra then. That plan failed royally. Okay. I mean, I know we have a Plantera wall like right here. No, wait, it's right here. Okay, you're unnecessary. Now, question is, what can we do to beat Plantera? As an expert mode, Plantera is much better. Okay. I'm really drawing a blank. Could do. Okay. Let's see if the guide tell us about any. These aren't really useful. Skin stuff. Battle. It's water. Okay. Actually, we do have the whatever it's called. We do have that thing from way back. Not way back. That thing. The arena over here. Like, we could move this trophy setup to down. Then we could, I don't know. Plantera is definitely the... Plantera followed by... Well, Lantera is probably the second strongest boss in this game. Well, rather, that's incredibly difficult to beat with the equipment you have beforehand. And is a necessary part of that tier progression. I'm not really counting Duke Fishron in that so much, as you can fight him like after the frog. And the weapons are there. So that's that. Yeah, I'm really not sure. Yeah. Probably move the... That was intentional. I'm not even sure how that happened. Let's just put this back then. An option would be to use a minecart. Actually, I could attempt to use a minecart track. That just like goes around in a large circle. Like if we take this, make it go like up here. Then do something like this. Make like a large circle that we can continue going. That might actually work. And with various, like, and with one healing station. Right at the end. Like right near here. So that it builds up as we're going. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Thinking we're going to go with that. So I'm going to leave doing that till the next episode. Then we'll have another Terraria fight. So if you enjoyed the video. Well, okay, before I sign off, yeah, this is probably a shorter episode. Building that first arena was quite time consuming. Even though it failed spectacularly. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.